Still here on this Wednesday edition of the SportsMax Zone, and we turn our attention to news around one of the greatest athletes of our generation, the Pocket Rocket, Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce. Now, the Pocket Rocket Foundation held its official scholarship award ceremony earlier on Wednesday at the AC Hotel in Kingston, and with the disappointment of Pryce 2024 still fresh in the minds of fans worldwide, the three-time Olympic champion had a message for her supporters.
We're so proud of the support that I get from home. It's truly something that continues to hold me up, and to see the love and the support from my fellow Jamaicans is truly something that I'm grateful for. And I just want to say thank you guys for your support. Thank you for all that you continue to do for the Pocket Rocket, and continue to, you know, just hold that belief that at the end of the day, things happen and we can't control everything that happens, but we too can, you know, just navigate that journey. And I'm glad that I have them with me. And I think, as the Jamaicans would say, we're little but we're tallower. So that continues to be a motto that we hold dear to our hearts.
Yeah, and when asked if this could be it for her athletics journey, Fraser-Pryce was coy in her response.
I cannot answer that question currently, but thank you so much for coming to the Pocket Rocket Foundation Scholarship Handover. We're truly excited that you guys are here with us, and we look forward to welcoming you to the six-a-side football competition in October. Thank you.
Yeah, the Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce Pocket Rocket Foundation has increased the number of scholarship recipients from 11 last year to 20 this year. And Fraser-Pryce also spoke to the foundation's legacy, specifically a former recipient, Janie Brown, competing at the Paris Olympics.
Be able to come back from, you know, just her own, you know, obstacles, and be able to make it on the Team Jamaica, to be able to stand at the Olympics is truly remarkable. And for me, here at the Pocket Rocket Foundation, we believe in lasting change, and not lasting change in one day or one year, but continuous change. And that takes time and it takes effort. So I'm truly grateful to be able to witness that evolution for her. And as the chairperson of the Pocket Rocket Foundation, I would also like to extend that to her, you know, a congratulations. And not only that, I hope that she continues to rise.
Yeah, Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce, one of the greats of sport, certainly of track and field. Donald Oliver, interesting comments coming from Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce. I can't answer that at the moment, is what she says as it relates to her future in track and field. Do remember that at early this year, she said it would be her last Olympic Games. In fact, at the time, many felt that what she was saying is that it would be her last year competing in track and field. And I think it became apparent later in the season that there was consideration for her to go beyond the Paris Olympic Games. Massive disappointment in Paris. She has not yet spoken about that. And she says she's not yet ready to speak about what the future holds for her or how she plans to move forward.
I think she actually has addressed it in the documentary that hasn't been released as yet. No, I'm not kidding.
Are you doing that documentary?
I wasn't called.
Okay. I thought you'd say I wish.
No, I wasn't called. But on a serious note, though, like it speaks to an overall thing that I have an issue with. And yes, maybe all will be revealed in her own time in terms of the documentary that she's doing with her sponsors. But our athletes, especially in the Caribbean, they have a tendency to go out of the limelight in silence. Mm. I am not sure if this lady deserves it. Mm. I remember, well, we all know the story of Usain Bolt and him wanting to leave at a particular time, and his sponsors asked him to stay for 1 year. He didn't necessarily leave out on top, did he? He left with injury, yes. I believe. And that, I think, put a donor on it. Didn't tarnish his legacy, obviously, but it was a bit of a damper in terms of closure. But in that final year, we knew it was going to be Usain Bolt's final year, and he went all around Europe, and he, of course, had his last race in Jamaica at the Racers Grand Prix, and it was just an outpouring of emotion, because as a nation and as the track and field world, we're grateful to have experienced Usain St. Leo Bolt. the issue that I'm having is that most athletes don't necessarily go that route. They keep it close to their chest, and then maybe an injury comes up, and then they just don't run again. There is no announcement. There is no send-off. And I think, especially a legendary athlete like Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce, I don't think she deserves that. But at the same time, she's in control of her own destiny. I remember when we were trying to reach out to her camp to get something from her as we prepared for the Paris Olympic Games, and it was difficult to secure an interview with her because, well, for whatever reason, we don't know the specific reason, but she just didn't want to comment on Paris and what was to come in the immediate future. And our prerogative was to really exalt her heading into her final Olympic Games. We were unable to do that. We had to go back to an interview that was done several years before to put together a piece that would form part of us at SportsMax honoring her. And that's just an issue that I've had, not only with this outgoing legend, Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce, but with other athletes who have graced the international stage, have done well, and they just go off into the sunset without recognition. And I'm just a little bit afraid that the same thing will happen with Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce, that she leaves, she probably has run her last race, and that's it. There is no send-off. There's no fanfare. She doesn't go on this world tour. She doesn't have her final race officially in Jamaica. And she just disappears. And the next time we see her, she's probably doing an interview about her Pocket Rocket Foundation and other stuff. She doesn't deserve that. And she needs to be aware that she doesn't deserve that.
Yeah, fair point. What I will say, though, is that the opportunity is still there for her to have what you have just suggested. A final season, a proper send-off in Jamaica, a world tour.
I'm just taking it at her word that she said that she doesn't know if she's going to be continuing or not. So I'm just operating on what she has just said.
She can't answer that right now.
Mm-hmm.
What that does say to me, though, is that she expects to be able to answer it in good time. And good time, for me at least, would mean before the start of the next season. Because I suspect that given her legendary status, it has to be part of the plan that she is going to have a final season where she will be given worthy send-offs right across the world, not just in Jamaica.
Yeah.
So there is that aspect. So I will say the opportunity is still there for that. The other aspect about what you brought up, 2024, and just trying to get access to glorify her career in the build-up to the Paris Olympic Games. I found it strange in 2024 that Shelly did not speak a lot to the media, which in truth is unlike her.
That's true.
Because
that is true.
That's not the way for majority of her career she has been. She's always been very accessible to the media, but there was something very different about 2024. Even when she finally opened her season in Kingston, she didn't speak after that race. She didn't want to speak after that race. She only spoke when she made the team following the national championships or on the night that she made the team at the national championships. So there are two things. You pointed to one of them, that all things will be revealed in a documentary that is being done. Or a lot is going on around her and she really does not have the answers to the questions that she knows will be posed, especially by the Jamaican media. And I wonder if she's thinking to herself, because I really don't know, it's in my best interest at the moment not to talk about it. No, having said that, I would suspect she would know how she feels about what happened at the Olympic Games in Paris.
Because that was very much in the past.
Yes.
It can be spoken about.
Yes, because we're still wondering what happened in Paris. We're still not really clear as to
the sequence of events.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And what actually caused the final withdrawal. Of mm-hmm. course, we have heard several different things in different places, whether it is that it was an injury ultimately, or was the fact that she was denied access to the facility.
Or didn't warm up well enough.
Or didn't warm up mm-hmm. properly, and so she decided not to take a risk. Mm. We've heard so many things, but we really don't know. And so I know that I am eager to find out, and I know that many fans are eager to find out as well as to what really went down. But as Shelly says,
we'll probably see it on Netflix.
She's not in a position to talk about it just yet. But I can't wait, Shelly. I honestly can't wait. I hope you'll talk to us about it soon.
And I hope the documentary does her justice.
Yes, mm-hmm. I hope so too. But whatever happens, Shelly, just remember, we love you because you have been an amazing servant for Jamaica, for the Caribbean, and you have been an amazing example of what a role model should be for many right across the world. So thank you very much. Let's take a break on the SportsMax Zone. So much more to come, including Donald's favorite sport and team, Manchester United. They were at home in the Europa League and they didn't win.
I prefer not to speak. I prefer not to speak.